अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट होम। आई एम योर साइंस टीचर साहर फ्रॉम मुल्तान पब्लिक स्कूल एंड कॉलेज। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर लेसन। डियर स्टूडेंट, प्लीज़ ओपन योर बुक्स, पेज नंबर 68, चैप्टर नंबर 3। आवर टूडे टॉपिक इज़ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस। देयर आर मैनी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस। नंबर 1, मैग्नेटिक फोर्स। नंबर 2, इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स। नंबर 3, ग्रेविटी। नंबर 4, फ्रिक्शन। मैग्नेटिक फोर्स। मैग्नेट्स कैन अट्रैक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट्स मेड ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मटीरियल्स सच एज आयरन एंड स्टील। दे कैन पुल दीज ऑब्जेक्ट्स टूवर्ड्स दैम। दीज आर अनलाइक पोल्स एंड अनलाइक पोल्स ऑफ मैग्नेट कैन ऑल्सो अट्रैक्ट ईच अदर। The pull of magnet is called the magnetic force of attraction. Dear students, these are like poles. Like poles of magnets repel by pushing each other away. The force between two like poles of magnets is the magnetic force of repulsion. Non-contact force. Dear student, does a magnet need to touch a magnetic material or any other magnet to exert a force on it? A magnet can exert a force on other magnets or magnetic materials without being in contact with them. A magnetic force is a non-contact force. It can act on any other object without touching it. Electric force. First, we define that what is electric force. The force between electric charges is called electric force. This is the experiment. Dear student, if you look at this diagram, rub a balloon on your clothes for about 30 seconds. What happens when you bring the balloon to your hair or towards some small pieces of paper? When we rub the balloon on our clothes, the balloon become electrically charged. The charged balloon is then able to attract our hair or the pieces of paper, which also has electric charges. The force between electric charges is called electric force. Dear student, like magnetic force, electric force is a non-contact force. It can act on any other object without touching it. Gravity. Dear student, no matter how high we jump, we will land back on the ground. We do not stay up in the air. Why is that so? Yes, dear student, we land on ground because there is a force pulling us down. This force is called gravitational force or gravity. And definition of gravity: gravity is the force of attraction between two objects. Dear students, look at skydivers in the photograph. Do you think they will eventually land on the ground? Yes, dear students, they land on the ground because there is a force of pulling us. This force is called gravitational force or gravity. Dear student, there is a force of attraction between the earth and any object near the surface of the earth. That is why objects in the air always fall to the ground towards the center of the earth. Friction. First, we define that what is friction. Friction is a force which goes against motion when two surfaces are in contact. It acts in the opposite direction to the motion. Friction is a contact force, unlike magnetic, electric, and gravitational force. Experiment. Dear student, if you look at this diagram, when Ali pushes a wooden block on a table, it starts to move. After a short while, it slows down and stops. A force is acting on the wooden block as it moves. This force is called frictional force or friction. It makes the moving wooden block slow down and eventually stop. Another example of friction, when we are walking, there is friction between our shoes and the ground. If there is little or no friction, we should slip and fall. Our last topic is measuring forces. Dear student, forces can be measured by instruments called force meter. A force meter are also called Newton meter or spring balance. Dear student, this is the diagram of spring balance. Forces are measured in units called newtons. The unit Newton is named after the famous scientist Sir Isaac Newton. Its symbol is N. The spring balance can also be used to measure the weight of objects. Dear student, this is our end of this lesson. Thank you and goodbye.